slim, mate.
You looking slim, mate? I've got my teeth whitened.
Oh, look at you. Don't get any clubs with UV lights.
No. So, mate, so I've had your boat now for, how long have I had it now? A couple of months?
Since just after the, probably, yeah, a couple of months, just after.
Yeah, so I haven't been adding it that much because of the weather, but I have been to Great Barrier. I have been to the top of New Zealand in my 5.15 metre boat. And at first I was a bit scared, mate, going all the way in little boats, but now I'm just sweet as, mate.
Yeah.
No problem. And probably the biggest question I get asked about the boat, mate, is about the bow.
Yeah.
Yeah. So maybe you can tell the viewers, mate, who are watching right now, what's the deal with this bow? Because it looks different. Some people say it looks weird. Some people like it. Some people don't like the shape of it. But it's not about the, how it looks to you so much as the performance, right? So why don't you tell the people behind the camera there why you've made a bow like this, mate?
So when I was over in Europe doing a whole lot of professional sailing, I came across a boat called a Wally Tender. It's a 40-foot carbon fibre boat with a bow pretty much exactly the same as this, a little bit different, but that thing went over 50 knots and it was awesome. And we went for a ride and I thought, this will fix a tin boat for sure. So yeah, I gave it a go 6 years ago, designed the boat like this, and here we are today. And so this part of the bow here has got about a 70 degree angle like this, so this actually cuts into the waves instead of bouncing off them, and then you get your hydrodynamic lift or your, from the hull, and that's quite subtle, but you get a little bit more extra buoyancy in the front of the boat too, so it cuts in and then pops out the back of the waves instead of just bouncing off them like your standard design tin boat. So yeah, it greatly reduces the pitching and the slamming, because down in the slam zone down the bottom there, it's 45 degrees instead of 30 to 36, which is pretty much your standard in all the other manufacturers. So from that point of view, the whole concept of the bow is designed just to slice in and pop out the back instead of pound. So, and yeah, I wouldn't be building them today if they didn't work. So the end result with the setup is you get a boat that rides a lot better than a normal boat with this bow design. So the consequences of having a bow designed this way is you end up with a lot more room inside the boat. The bunk in this 585 is 1.8 meters long and you've still got ample cockpit room for four guys. So let's go check it out. So just to show you guys the big benefit of the bow with the internal volumes of the boat, like on a sort of standard setup with the raking bow, it'll come through sort of through the, on this angle through here. So you lose about 300 to 400 mil in the front of the cabin. So instead of having a 1.8 metre bunk, you've probably got a bunk about 1.5 metres long and sort of in a 6 metre overall length sort of boat. So this boat's 1.8 metres in a straight line, so on the angle it's about 1.9 to 1.95 metres, so you can quite happily overnight in this 585. There's plenty of room up here. It's not that comfortable at the moment because there's no bunks in here. But as you can see... Heaps of space, and I've still got some headroom back here.